there. I'm Dave Householder, and I am blessed to send you these daily encouraging Bible lessons. And I invite you to pass them on to people who are less than encouraged right now, because these can be discouraging times. The news is challenging to watch, to say the least. I was talking to one of the early founders of Intel this morning. And not that he's an expert on pandemics, but he really believes, statistically speaking, he's a stats guy, that this could go on for 2 or 3 years if we don't find a vaccination. That being the case, it's important that we keep our spirits strong and our souls strong and our minds strong, and to continue to be encouraged and to react well to situations. Our circumstances don't determine our well-being. Our response to our circumstances determines our well-being. So I think it's so important that we're intentional about our response, and people of faith should respond out of faith, not out of fear. We're looking at Mark 9 today. Mark 9, verses 22 and 23. Let me set the stage for you if I could. Jesus is encountered with a boy who is having what appears to be like an epileptic seizure, although it seems to have some spiritual demonic connotations to it. And of course, parents get really upset in times like that. And one of them asks Jesus in verse 22, if you are able to do something, please do something for us. Please help us. Now, he was just being polite, of course, but Jesus was not always the most gentle of responders. Basically responded with, what do you mean, if I can? Kind of, I'm not saying he was drinking beer, but Jesus could have said, hold my beer, watch this. No, I'm just basically saying here that Jesus was responding aggressively to a very polite question. And that's a sort of typical Midwestern way of going back and forth. It's a little edgy compared to the conversational style we most North Americans have, especially in California, where they're kind of relaxed and cruisy and it's all good. You know, that's not the way people talk in the Middle East then or now. And so he's responded, yeah, watch this, watch this. I can do this. And basically he says in the original Greek, all things are possible for those who believe. Now, let me say something about the original Greek. Jesus never spoke the original Greek. I'm not saying never, but his main language was Aramaic. And Aramaic and Greek are as different as night and day, completely different language systems, completely different everything. And in the Aramaic, I'm able to find, now we don't have Aramaic records of what Jesus said, but we do have Aramaic versions of the Bible. And it says, basically, anything can happen for those who believe. And I think that that's a beautiful way of looking at it. Rather than just all things are possible, anything can happen for those who believe. All things are possible is also a good translation, but anything can happen just sort of makes me think about the way the universe is put together, the way the creation is put together. If you go down to the lower subatomic level, you're looking at pure energy. There really is no such thing as solid matter. At the lowest level, you start cutting everything apart and moving it to its smallest Lego pieces or Minecraft pieces. You end up with nothing but energy floating around, energy that seems to be connected to consciousness, because if you measure anything at that level, it tends to move when you measure it as a result of your measuring. So it seems to know what you're doing. There's a beautiful randomness of nature at that level, of creation at that level. And it seems to me there's cause and effect at our level of the world, but that's an illusion, because at the very basic level of creation, anything can happen. And our consciousness and our thinking affects what happens. Basically, the American economy is what we believe it is. The dollar is worth what we believe it's worth. The stock market reflects our psychology as much as it does any real numbers. And people say, well, you know, hey, we should base our money on a gold standard. Well, the gold is only worth what we think it is too. Everything is based on faith. For those who have faith, anything can happen. And the biblical worldview is a whole different worldview. The biblical worldview is that the spiritual and the physical are closely connected. It goes back to Genesis 1, and these beautiful forces are singing together and in harmony together and always operating together. It's not like we have the physical world and there's heaven out here and occasionally heaven breaks in and changes the rules and there's a miracle. No, a miracle is possible at any moment. All kinds of things can happen, and there are a lot more possible outcomes than what we believe. A lot of people say, well, this thing's going to last 2 or 3 years, this COVID. And other people say, oh, we're going to have a vaccination by such and such. And there are so many possible outcomes. So many things can happen in your life, in the life of the world. And I would like you to just think about that. Next time somebody's are so sure with their opinions, oh, this is going to happen, or that's going to happen, or this person's going to get elected, or that person's going to get elected. Just remember, for those who believe, anything can happen. God's power can jump in and surprise us at any moment. That's the good news for today, and I will see you again tomorrow.